has a 3-bar V-trigger. 3 V-reversals available to him, which means he's going to be able to do it much more often.
Yeah, just got himself mostly out of the corner now.
Yeah, pressure now. There's a lot of gray up there, so the throw does extra damage. Ooh, the backdash in the corner. He knew what to expect. And a backdash from Moke.
Wow,
but
back and forth, but Knuckledew is going to get the final throw.
Yeah,
he's
Knuckledew.
He's going to take that first round.
Great throw, and he's shown extreme awareness in this matchup. You saw when the V-Trigger came out, he walked up and did the throw tech OS. You can, you know, throw after that and kind of OS it. If Rashid comes in, you get the throw. If he stays away, you're stuck in block stun from the tornado, so it doesn't come out. Cheeky little option select that allows you to deal with that scenario. Showing very high knowledge in the matchup.
All right, now here comes Moke. Has Knuckledew in the corner now, but let's see what he can make out of this, because last time he got a little bit, but it just wasn't enough.
Yeah, exactly. You got to really, if you're Rashid, this is where you have to win the match, right? Right here, because if you don't, you're going to be in big trouble.
All right, so here we go. Opportunity now, but you can see almost a little bit of tentative play from him. Gets the crush counter sweep. He's going to be able to convert into some good damage there. But Knuckledew still, okay, he's out of the corner now. So now
oh,
it's
wow, punish opportunity. Yeah, he goes for the Crouching Fierce. Maybe thought it would be a crush, but it wasn't.
Right.
The Eagle Spike. And there
oh,
it is.
Couldn't quite make it over there. And yeah, now that he's out of the corner, you can see just whittling away at the damage little by little. And just like that, he is caught up in life already.
That back fierce, dangerous button now for Knuckledew. If he lands it, crush counter, and he can combo right into the critical art. So you got to be very careful. Wow, caught him low.
And that's enough. So Moke is going to take round number two.
Big low medium kick from Moke that dash up right into activation. Combos into the V-Trigger. Big opportunity now. Knuckledew with lots of resources. Oh!
Ooh, just a start with a crush counter, and that's going to be all the way into the corner for Moke. It's a great start for him.
Patient defense. Knuckledew with a tech and a V-reversal out. This allows him to escape, but punish on the landing frames of that.
It's a couple of times that he's done that now.
There was no trip guard.
There was no trip guard.
Could not. What a dash under from Knuckledew. He's got corner pressure and positioning is all his.
But he's going to back up on the hood. Yep, exactly. But there we go. Right back in there with that EX Eagle Spike.
That Ride the Lightning. It's like we're watching Machibo Sin.
Well, no one was watching him in top 8 right now. But in any case, Guile jumping back. Knuckledew trying to just stay away from that tornado as much as possible. Wow!
Whoa! The awareness not to get hit by the tail end of the tornado and the throw bait. There he is, Knuckledew. You see on his face how much this means to him, how much this matters after Capcom Cup last year. He really hasn't had the performances you expect, right? He had a super solid start to the year, but since then, maybe not what people expect from the champ. So very interesting. You know, one match now.
It's always tough because, like, he talked about it, too, after he won. You know, that pressure, he has to deal with that pressure, how tough it is. But so far this year, despite not winning everything, I still think he's holding up pretty well.
Yeah, it's very difficult when all eyes are on you. I think Punk has taken a lot of that pressure off of him by really being the man to look out for, especially here at EVO. And Moke, you know, the surprise pick, a lot of people who don't study CFN, who only watch the matches, you know, they haven't seen this guy before, but he's incredibly talented.
A lot of those guys hidden at home playing online.
Crush the back dash. He's going to get the pickup here. EX, the rolling instead, and the jump in. And yeah, you saw it looked like a reversal there. You can't get away with that regular flash kick, right? It's got to be EX.
You can hit it low enough, and it's not invincible right away.
See the adjustment now from Moke. A lot more dashing. He knows Knuckledew is waiting to see his movement before striking, and that's why he's catching little stuff like that overhead. Moke has realized Knuckledew is waiting and seeing, so he's giving him harder things to look at.
The nice thing so far, though, is that Knuckledew, his timing on the V-reversals have been good. They've actually been connecting and not getting blocked.
Yeah, that's matchup knowledge.
Yeah. All right, so now he has his corner position. Yeah, he knew he was going to come off the wall, so he had the flash kick all ready for him. But again, that crouching medium kick and, of course, the Eagle Spike to send him back into the corner. That's the beauty of that EX.
Brutal scenario now for Knuckledew. He's got a guess. Now he's in big trouble, the kill range. He's got V-Trigger available. He's looking for that light kick into the CA, but the boom activation is a no-go. Moke Rashid gets the job done.
There you go. So now it's 1-1 between these two players. Again, winner of this does make top 8.
In the bracket, yes.
We will see them tomorrow on the big stage.
Top 8 winners on the line here for these two. And Moke, this would be a big breakout for him all the way from Japan. He's got a lot of CPT points because of that online event. You can check the standings. He was, you know, 110 Bison Bucks on that fantasy bracket for a reason, right? Very talented player. And I think somebody who, in the fantasy brackets especially, people didn't know who he was. And here he is on the EVO stage.
Potentially paying out for all those fantasy bucks right now. But Knuckledew doing a good job here, staying in the middle of the stage. He is doing a good job of not letting Moke push him back right now.
Yeah, Rashid, absurd corner carry, obviously. One of the best characters at getting you there. You can see the enhanced mixer allows him to get right in there. Flash kick, he'll take that trade.
Yeah, any day. And then there's that anti-Rashid tech right there. Flash kicking in between the...
Oh, that was a knuckle-do round until that crush counter, and he was looking very comfortable. Ooh. I think he tried to be reversal, actually, but he was a little early on the strike.
He just walked into the second hit of that towards medium punch, so he got counter-hit, and Moke was able to confirm. Down's just almost no life left.
Knuckle-do getting the booms out. The EX, ooh, he's going to get the punish, and Knuckle-do one round from Evo top eight.
That was Moke betting it all. If he had landed that, obviously, he would have won the round.
You gotta know, if that's the mindset Moke is willing to have, Knuckle-Doo's gotta recognize it, right? See that he's willing to take those risks.
Right, well, Knuckle-Doo, once again, just trying to keep himself away from that corner, because that's exactly where Moke is gonna get everything going. You remember that round where he had like three throws in a row and it's starting again? But yeah, waking up with buttons from Knuckle-Doo that time.
The patience, he gets the beer reversal guaranteed on that forward medium punch, two hits of it, and he escapes the corner, huge.
That is really important for him, but Rashid, the master of every confirm, being able to switch sides, pick which corner you're at.
Eagle Spike, he can actually throw an EX boom, you have to dissipate the rest of that tornado, didn't get a chance to do it, but the idea was there from Knuckle-Doo.
Here we go, now he has a beam reversal, but again, a crucial back throw, and now it's Knuckle-Doo's turn for this corner pressure.
Ooh, he's very dangerous. If there's that V-trigger activation, Dude does have CA, so if he can find a little bit more chip, it actually is a threat.
He doesn't even need the chip. He's going to take it with the critical art, and you can see the relief on Knuckle-Doo's face. He has made it to the big stage tomorrow, top eight at Evolution.